Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and gracious Father, we give you thanks for the fruits of the earth in their season and for the labors of those who harvest them. Make us, we pray, faithful stewards of your great bounty for the provision of our necessities and the relief of all who are in need, to the glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Take some of the first of all the fruit of the ground, The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When the crowd found Jesus on the other side of the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal." Then they said to him, "What must we do to perform the works of God?" Jesus answered them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." So they said to him, "What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing?" "Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, 'He gave them bread from heaven to eat.'" Then Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be alway acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Welcome to this special service of worship at St. Paul's. If you're visiting, you might have read the welcome message on the front cover of the bulletin. It says that no matter who you are welcome in this church. No matter where you are from, you are welcome in this church. No matter what you said to your better half or to your children before you arrived, you are still welcome in this church. And no matter how messy your life really is, you are welcome in this church. In fact, we are glad to have you among us. And that's a radical statement. As I like to say, it's information. It tells you something about who we are. It tells ourselves something about who we are and who we hope to become. It's a radical statement because it is opposed to how much of the world behaves, where who you are in the eyes of others determines your status, your position, your value to the community, and membership in or out of this place or that place. So why are we making these claims, and why would we even behave that way? As one of my favorite spiritual leaders puts it, "God has no taste whatsoever. It's positively disgusting. He loves everyone." Why do we invite and welcome people of difference difference in education, difference in culture, in wealth, in skin color, belief, everything. What holds it all together in this community? We try to be welcoming because this is who we believe God to be. God created all that is. God created humankind. Male and female, God created them in God's image. God created difference. In my 20s, I was at a cocktail party talking with an ancient matriarch of that community. And she criticized someone, and I responded, "Well, it takes all kinds." "Honey," she said, "it don't take all kinds. We just got all kinds." She was more right than I think she knew. Because God made us this way. All kinds. And I think God made us different so that we could learn the true value of relationship. God created us for relationship with God and with each other. And what holds all this mess of difference together is God's love for us through the life of Jesus Christ. We gather here to give thanks, to offer prayers together in thanks for all that we are and all that we have been and all that we may yet become. We gather around the table of the Lord to receive the mystery of Holy Communion. Around that altar, our differences matter not, because we eat the one bread and we drink the one cup. The bread of life and the cup of blessing, the cup of healing. We are made one people by God's radical invitation to love one another just the way God loves us. And when you know that truth, that you are loved and you are accepted and you are a child of the living God, when you know it in your bones, then when you turn around and leave this place, you throw the doors open and you invite everyone to come back with you, to receive what you have received. The same forgiveness, the same healing, the same hope. You want everyone to become a part of the community of people who follow the way of Jesus. And that is what we strive to be here at St. Paul's, to follow Jesus, to love others by giving what we have been given. Think about that. The knowledge of salvation. Share it. The assurance that nothing known or yet known may ever separate us from the love of God. Share it. The forgiveness of sins. That whatever shame you bear, whatever wrong thing you have done, every one of us has them. No one is free from that. Until God releases you from it. When you ask for it, God is there and God releases you, unbinds you from what has bound you, unbinds you from what weighs you down and keeps you from being everything God dreams you to be. Tomorrow is a special day in our land where we offer thanks. In this community, we know to whom we offer thanks and gratitude: to God through Jesus. We offer thanks for what we have, yes, we do. But we are also called to remember those who do not have even enough to sustain their lives. And we are to share our abundance so that no child of God suffers the indignity of deprivation. No one. Personally, I give thanks to God that I exist. That is more than I ever could have hoped for. I give thanks for each and every person who's here tonight and who is connected to our church and to St. Paul's. And I pray that when we together in a few minutes, that when we pray the great Thanksgiving, the Holy Eucharist, and we gather at the altar rail, that we know that God is for us. Know that God is for you. Know that that the gift that we are about to receive is something that no human hands can make or diminish. Receive in your hands God's love unbounded. Consume it. Become one with your Creator. And then when worship concludes, as I said, go out of these doors into the world, filled and blessed and healed and made new, and share that with every person you meet. Everyone. Be disgusting with your love. Share it with everyone. Amen.
Let us stand and affirm our faith with the word of the Nicene. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten. Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray, not as we ask in our ignorance, nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone.
And so hold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Good to have all of you with us here this evening, this Thanksgiving Eve, as we gather to give thanks, as John said, for the many blessings that we have and the many blessings that we can share. I would like to mention that we, as usual at this service, have a gift for you as you leave. Mary Chandler, who for a number of years has labored diligently in the weeks before Thanksgiving, has made small loaves of bread as a gift to us. So after you receive communion, we will have the bread over here on by these steps, and if you receive at the pulpit station, there's some bread over here. Please pick up like one loaf per family and enjoy it with your Thanksgiving meal, and know that it comes with the love of this parish family. All the other announcements I am going to let you read on your own. If you are visiting, we hope you will come back and visit us at some other time. But again, have a wonderful Thanksgiving, giving thanks for the blessings that we all have received. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Bless, O Lord, this bread, we pray, made with loving hands, that those who will enjoy it may be ever reminded of the many blessings that they have received and the love that they have been received as well. And all this we say in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise. At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets and their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home. From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another. Again and again, you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law and to open the way of freedom and peace. By his blood, you reconciled us. And therefore, we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn. And so, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving, we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming. Lord God of our fathers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name. Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread. Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. This is the table not of the church, but of the Lord. It is made ready for those who love him and for those who want to love him more. So come, you who have much faith, and you who have little. You who have been here often, and you who have not been here long. You who have tried to follow, and you who have failed. Come, because it is the Lord who invites you. It is his will that those who want him should meet him here.